Let's see linting inside Visual Studio Code. So what I want to highlight, I'm going to hit Control-Shift-P here, is the fact that off of here, we'll slide on over, there we go, that we have the ability to enable linting. Obviously, you can set that to be on or off. You can tell it, hey, I want you to run the linter now. And you're also going to notice the fact that we have the ability to select a linter. Now, if you check out the Visual Studio Code docs, what you're going to notice is the fact that the linter that they've enabled here, or I should say, the settings that they've enabled on the linter are relatively low level, let's say, that it's not going to give you warnings on every last little thing. So you'll notice, for example, that sometimes on spaces, I mentioned before the no extraneous spaces, that by default, Visual Studio Code is not going to give you errors about those. And you know, that's fine, and you can go ahead and decide the level to which you want to turn on the linter. You can go in and set up your configuration file. But I do want to show you this in action. So I'm going to just real quick here say x equals 42, and I'm going to put a semicolon at the end there, so that way you can see what happens. And when I hit a carriage return, you're going to notice that that turns to red, but I'm not getting any actual error message here. But when I save, that's when my linter is going to run. And now you're going to notice right here is my little yellow squiggly. And if I hold my mouse over that, now you're going to notice that it tells me, hey, you have an unnecessary semicolon. So now what I can do is I can get rid of that. And if I hit save again, now you'll notice that the squigglies go away. So it's that save that will automatically run the linter for me. Now, one big thing that linters can really help you out with is if you had something like this, where maybe I create a function and I say return some word there, and then I say print hello. The catch that I have here, the problem that I have, is the fact that print is not going to be reachable. That I said return, then I put something underneath that. One of the things that I find myself very commonly doing is messing up the end of a function. I'll openly admit this, that I'll like forget to return a value, or I'll put a return in the wrong spot. I do weird things simply because of the fact that I'm so focused in on the code that I'm writing and not always focused, or I should say the problem that I'm solving, and not always focused in on the code that I'm writing. So it will sometimes catch me. So that's just, you know, a couple of the different things that the linter can do for me inside of Visual Studio Code. And again, you can go in and configure this. The other thing that I want to highlight here is this little print hello. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to get rid of everything here. And I'm going to sneak down here, and I'm going to say print hello. And when I do this, what you're going to notice is that IntelliSense is only able to give me one very basic piece of information, the name of the parameter. And that's it. And granted, for a simple function like this, that's just fine. But what happens if you have a complex function where maybe you've got 15 different parameters, and it's not necessarily always clear as to what your parameters are going to be doing? And maybe it's not clear based on your function whether or not it's going to have side effects or whether or not it's going to return a value. This is where those type hints and that doc string comes into play. So what I can do is I can say, hey, this is going to be a string. And I can say, hey, it's going to return a string. And so now, when I go in and I say print hello, now you're going to notice that my IntelliSense is updated. Now I can see, oh, my parameter type is a string. And I can also see that it's going to return a string. And again, if I add in the doc string, and I'm just going to do it manually here real quick. Boom, 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 boom. Now I can do a real quick description, returns a greeting. I can then add in maybe a parameter section. So I'll say name maybe indicate that this is a string, and then say the name of the person, and then I could say returns, and then I can say the cool message. So now that I've got that, let me sneak back down here, and now let me one more time go to print hello. Now, what I want you to notice is that the IntelliSense is giving me a lot of great information. Now I can see that this is going to return a greeting, I can see my parameters, and I can also see the return value. And all of that was enabled by a doc string. Now, you are going to notice that when we go through the rest of our demos, as much of a fan as I am of always coding with best practices, you are going to notice we're not necessarily going to be using doc strings. We're not necessarily going to be using type hints. And this is something where we should probably all be in a better habit of that. But you are going to notice, especially when it comes to type hints, that type hints aren't really all that popular yet in the Python community. For me personally, again, this is me, Christopher, talking. I really do hope that this continues to grow and continues to catch on, that the big reason that I use TypeScript as opposed to JavaScript is for exactly this reason, that I love that typing. I love being able to see very quickly, very easily, what's going on. And so that really does help out. So for our simple little demos, you're going to notice I'm not going to put that in, but I strongly do recommend for code that you're going to be writing for real that you do go in and update all of that. So make sure that you are putting in your type hints for anything that's going to be called outside of your application, especially if you're going to be sharing this with others. Make sure that you do put in the doc strings as well. All right, so that's how we can use type hints. That's how we can use doc strings.